with many a dream. A long, long time. Listen to the word and watch the kids, and everybody's had a good day, I think. We praise the Lord for it. Let's all look unto Him right now. Father, we love You. We are thankful to be in Your midst tonight, O God. Bless us, we pray. Lift us up together in the heavenly places, O God. Bless the people of God across the land, and bless the church and everywhere we've been together in Your name. And we'll thank You for it, Lord, and praise You for it. In Jesus' name, amen.
Yeah. through the tears that made her blind. You see, she felt such pain. Some even spoke in anger. She heard folks whisper, "There's no place here."
Until
Yeah.
Then the soldiers of the governor took Jesus into the common hall and gathered unto him the whole band of soldiers. And they stripped him and put on him a scarlet robe. And when they had platted a crown of thorns, they put it upon his head and a reed in his right hand. And they bowed the knee before him and mocked him, saying, Hail, King of the Jews. And they spit upon him and took the reed and smote him on the head. And after that they had mocked him, they took the robe off from him and put his own raiment on him and led him away to crucify him. And as they came out, they found a man of Cyrene, Simon by name. Him they compelled to bear his cross. And when they were come unto a place called Golgotha, that is to say, a place of a skull, they gave him vinegar to drink, mingled with gall. And when he had tasted thereof, he would not drink. And they crucified him and parted his garments, casting lots, that it might be fulfilled which was spoken by the prophet. They parted my garments among them, and upon my vesture did they cast lots. And sitting down, they watched him there, and set up over his head his accusation written, This is Jesus, the King of the Jews.
Yeah.
and another on the left. And they that passed by reviled him, wagging their heads, and saying, Thou that destroyest the temple, and buildest it in 3 days, save thyself. If thou be the Son of God, come down from the cross. Likewise also the chief priests mocking him with the scribes and elders said, He saved others, himself he cannot save. If he be the King of Israel, let him now come down from the cross, and we will believe him. He trusted in God, let him deliver him now, if he will have him, for he said, I am the Son of God. The thieves also, which were crucified with him, cast the same in his teeth. Now from the sixth hour there was darkness over all the land unto the ninth hour. And about the ninth hour Jesus cried with a loud voice, saying, Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani? That is to say, my God, why hast thou forsaken me? Some of them that stood there, when they heard that, said, This man calleth for Elias. And straightway one of them ran, and took a sponge, and filled it with vinegar, and put it on a reed, and gave him to drink. The rest said, Let be, let us see whether Elias will come to save him. Jesus, when he had cried again with a loud voice, yielded up the ghost. And behold, the veil of the temple was rent in twain from the top to the bottom, and the earth did quake, and the rocks rent.
The sky was filled with darkness. Jesus died for my transgressions, and that he paid the price a long, long time ago. When he gave his life for me on a hill called Calvary. But there's something else I want to know.
Seems that I've
first day of the week, came Mary Magdalene and the other Mary to see the sepulchre. And behold, there was a great earthquake, for the angel of the Lord descended from heaven and came and rolled back the stone from the door and sat upon it. His countenance was like lightning, and his raiment white as snow. And for fear of him, the keepers did shake and became as dead men. And the angel answered and said unto the women, Fear not ye, for I know that ye seek Jesus, which was crucified. He is not here, for he is risen, as he said. Come, see the place where the Lord lay, and go quickly and tell his disciples that he is risen from the dead. And behold, he goeth before you into Galilee. There shall ye see him. Lo, I have told you. And they departed quickly from the sepulchre with fear and great joy, and did run to bring his disciples word. And as they went to tell his disciples, behold, Jesus met them, saying, All hail. And they came and held him by the feet and worshipped him. And when they saw him, they worshipped him, but some doubted. And Jesus came and spake unto them, saying, All power is given unto me in heaven and in earth. Go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded you. And lo, I am with you always, even unto the end of the world.
Yeah.
preaching. That's how preaching done in a song. Amen. I don't need to preach. And I think a lot of the scriptures that we read here, I had notes. This morning I taught on the 20th and the 21st chapter of John, and I found out that Jennifer taught it in Sunday school. And so the same statements I made, she made. She's been taught well, that's all I can say. And it was so good. It was so good. And then when Wendy was reading Matthew. That's what I got for tonight. The same scriptures in Matthew. I want to tell you what I learned through all of this is the thing of the Passover. And we don't really read it. We don't read it. Like it took 8 days to accomplish this thing, you know. And we think God don't do it right now. Amen. But I mean, he didn't even answer. He heard the request and he went his way and acted like he didn't want him to listen. And 8 days later, he come back and went right to... what does that mean?
No, I pinched my fingers.
He went right to...
Thomas.
Oh, what's your name? You know, I'll never forget what's your name. John. And he talks all through the scripture. John refers to that disciple whom Jesus loved. He don't want anybody, he don't want to be big, you know, but he knew Jesus loved him. And the reason, see, every one of those brothers, Jesus had his own reason. I've got a bunch of kids, and I love them all. Their ways and their reasons. And God is the same way. Peter he'd argue with you. He was hard to get along with. He had his mind set on what he wanted to do. But end up, he gave him the keys to the kingdom. Because he knew Peter was a go-getter, and he would go ahead and do it. I almost said the same things that she said about that very thing. And then John, he was a more introspective, and he knew who Jesus was. He had a revelation that he was more than baby Jesus. Amen. He'd be first to get there, and he'd sit, wait and see what Peter's going to do. Because Peter was a go-getter. But John was very wise. He didn't run in where the angels fared the tribe, you know? Now, I'm going to wait and see what this is. Let Peter go ahead and check it out, see what it's all about. And God loved him for that. Jesus loved him for that. So he loves you. Amen. For who you are. Amen. You don't have to be like me. I don't have to be like you.
Amen.
Let every man work out his own salvation. Amen. With fear and trembling. And I used to say, well, a lot of preachers don't give you this right, but I give you the right to disagree with you. Brother Pat, I don't agree with that. That's all right. Just don't stand around and fight with me. Let's just serve God anyhow.
Amen.
Amen. And you'd be surprised the number of times that people have said, I'll tell you, I don't agree with you at all on this. I don't agree with you on it. And later come back and say, you know, I believe he was right on that. It's happened many, many times. And a lot of times they don't see the in-depth of it. Brother Kevin was talking to me about that just the other day. About something I talked to him about 7 months back. And he wanted me to get on his side and be against this individual. But I couldn't do that. But still, I wasn't going to kill him with the truth. See, the truth is powerful. It's the truth. It's sharp. It's quick. And it can save your soul, but it can cut you to pieces too. And I didn't want to cut him to pieces. And I said, I know you don't understand what I'm saying, but somewhere down the road, you will. And then we get in these messes with the kid, we mess up. And then we begin to examine things and say, well, I walked into this, I caused this myself.
That's right.
Well, we can ain't then. You were the ticket it for me. But God revealed it to you, see?
Amen.
And he loves you for that. He loves you for that. He loves you for having your own mind. You don't have to accept everything just because somebody else does. But he wants us all to make it, children. He made a way that we could all be saved. I'm thankful for that. Thankful about the goodness of God. God is such a wonderful Savior. I love him tonight. It's been a great day. I'll chew on this and chew on this and chew on this. Carry around with me and chew on it. And I still chew on it because I... And I end up over Matthew. And all the things that he talked about. And the different ways he had to deal with people. Where he showed himself, not just once. Yeah, four times that we know of. Probably at least five when I got to looking again. That he showed himself before he ever went back to the Father. And so we think, well, why don't God answer me? Well, he may not come when you want him, but he's right on time. He's right on time. Just wait a little longer. Just wait a while. Believe God. Hold on to God. He's got his reasons. He's got his purposes. I don't know why I've had to go through what I went through. It's still going through. But I'm going to jump and shout again. Amen. I'm going to get down.
Get down.
Somebody said, get down. Get down. So they got down and said, get back up. Get back up. But anyway, but I love you. And I appreciate you. Couldn't have this church without you. Yes, indeed. We do have communion here. We have communion in sunrise service. And anybody that would like to take communion right now, just come and step forward. Amen. Don't get into that unworthy thing. He makes us work. We're worthy. Come on. We're all worthy. We're in a day of grace. The door's open, no man can shut it. Now there's going to come a time it'll be shut and no man can open it. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus.